Bonjour guys, it is me back again with another video. Now I'm not going to edit this video at all whatsoever. I'm just going to talk into this and I'm going to put it on YouTube and I'm going to see how it does. I'm going to do this two or three times just to see. It's a new year, let us try new things. Now today I want to talk to you guys about something I've been thinking about for the longest time. It's a new series. New series alert! Growing up, back when I was a little boy, I used to, like every night everyone would sit down and settle in front of the TV at 8 o'clock to watch the latest telenovela. Every single TV channel had its own telenovela, and for I think up to until 2012-2013 I was a telenovela head. My rice was cooking at the same time. But because I was a man, and I was kind of afraid of being bullied in school, I used to keep that to myself. And I also used to act in front of my mom or my big sister that I didn't really particularly care for the telenovelas. And it didn't really do, my mom didn't really help the situation because she banned me from watching wrestling because of violence and scantily clad women. And she'd let us watch telenovelas because I don't get it either. I don't understand. It doesn't make sense to me. Anyway. Now that I'm older, I kind of want to go back to the days when I would watch those cheesy soaps with like the really, really low budgets and all the bad writing, with all of them have practically the same story. When rich girl is dating rich boy. Rich boy sees poor girl who is pretty but has a soul of gold and falls for her. But evil girl cannot accept this. Why would she accept this? And she goes and does some nasty thing. Good girl finds out she's actually really, really rich, and then she comes back for revenge. So I made a list of, I need my glasses for this. I have my laptop down here, actually. I made a list of all of my, of the 10, my 10, I wouldn't really say favorite telenovelas of all time. I don't really think they're my favorite. It's because their songs have stuck in my head throughout my lifetime. Like, I know most of these songs almost word for word, bar for bar, practically. So I want to go back and I want to rewatch all of them and see, like, do they really still stack up? Do I still like them the way I used to as a kid? Have I grown out of them? I'm really curious about this. I don't know. So I'm going to make this a series where Mursal goes and watches the telenovelas. Now why? Why would I do that? Who? There's so much better TV out nowadays. If it's something I want, if it's something that's going to be in Spanish, there's so much good stuff on Netflix. I could just go watch that with higher quality and stuff. But no. When I was a little boy, you could not tell me there was a more attractive woman in this whole entire world than Maite Perroni. There's no way. To me, she was like a goddess. I was 11th girl. I thought to me, she was like, nah, you can't be more beautiful than Maite Perroni. It's impossible. Now I look at her, like, oh, she's cute, but you know, big booty. No, she don't have that. She don't have the big booty. I'm rambling right now. This video, it is completely freeform. I made a list. Yeah. If you're Kenyan, you know these soaps. If you don't know these soaps, you might not really be from Kenya. We might have to check the DNA. Ulikuwa wapi kabla kijana? Where were you? Now, number one, this soap I have to watch from start to finish. Storm Over Paradise, Tormento en el Paraíso. I need to see that again. Because I don't think there was a show that was more hyped growing up than that one. People love that show. Like, I really like to go to like one of the TV stations and see the ratings for these shows when they were all out and just compare viewership ratings between all of them. Because Storm of Pyrus was massive. Massive. Two, Ruby. Ruby, my personal favorite show, Ruby. Mainly because I really like the song. I really, really like it. La una descarada. Pero se más hermosa. La vida que se va, pero le gusta. La vida que hará. Y a mí me gustaría. I can go on for days, but I'm not going to do that. So let me not kill my vocals. Tafadhali. So it's Soul, you have to pay me for this one. Three, Don't Mess With An Angel. This is where I fell in love with Mighty Perón. She was so cute, so beautiful. Oh, I have to go see her again. This would really be useful if I could like put pictures like here or here or here like that, like show, okay, this is what I'm talking about. I'm not going to do that. If you know what I'm talking about, you know what I'm talking about. Oh my God, 6 minutes. Triunfo del Amor. Let me not lie to you. I know the song for this soap, but I don't remember what the soap is about. That's why you're going to have to rewatch them. And then there's Soy Tu Dueña. Which is about the city girl, who goes back to her hacienda back in somewhere in Mexico, and then the sexy horse hand guy there, Jose Miguel, he's like, yeah, I'm a macho man, and she's a city girl, she don't know nothing, and then she slowly but surely becomes more and more like a country don lady person. You know, like tragedy, and then they fall in love, but she doesn't want to admit the love, then blah blah blah, and then they fall in love, and you know, it was a great show, but it was the first time I ever saw a show where the heroine was like, if you watch anime or read manga, you would know she was like a really tsundere person, like super like, I don't really care, leave me alone, who do you think you are, but in her heart she's soft and mellow like an egg. And then, last but not least, Secreto de Amor. By far, the best telenovela, Secreto de Amor, has, in my opinion, the best opening song of all time. By the same name. In fact, I was singing it right now. And I'll put that video at the end of this video so you can see how I came up with the idea for making this video. But if you liked what you're about to see, if you didn't like what you just saw, write it down in the comments. Subscribe to your boy. I need views. please, I need views. If I lose my job, I'm only doing YouTube. Let me not lie to you. I'm telling you right now. This is just a test. I've been wanting to make videos more actively on YouTube, but honestly, I'm not really good with the time management, so I'm stuck between always being behind my work for work and behind my school work, so I never really have time to edit videos. Like, I can film the things in my sleep, like this is what I'm doing right now, but when it comes to actually making something that I feel like is worth being seen, it's really rough for me. So I promise I'm gonna do better. I'm gonna really try my best to at least give you guys one video a week. 2021, finally, I think this is gonna be my year. Now, like, subscribe, get your boy to 100 subs, and my beard is actually looking much better than I thought, even though I'm not really shaved or brushed or combed it in a while. Anyway, peace.
El nombre para guardar el secreto, porque te amo y me amas, y a alguien debemos respeto.
Te voy a cambiar
el nombre en base a lo que has traído. Te llamarás Gloria. Lo tienes bien merecido. Y hemos de darnos un beso encerrados en luna. Secreto amor te confieso, te quiero como a ninguna. Y puedo cambiar el nombre, pero no cambio la historia. Te llames como te llames, para mí tú eres la gloria.
Eres secreto de amor.
Secreto.
Eres secreto de amor.
Oye.
Eres secreto de amor.
Secreto.
Eres secreto de amor.
Delante de la gente no me envíes tus suspires. No me llames, aunque me ames. Delante de la gente soy amigo, muy testigo. Qué castigo.
Eres secreto de amor.
Secreto.
Eres secreto de amor.
Te voy a cambiar el nombre para guardar el secreto, porque te amo y me amas. No debo ser perfecto. Ay, secreto.
Eres secreto de amor.